Harper Audio presents Hobby Farming for Dummies by Theresa A. Husarik, read by Brett Barry. Copyright 2008 by Wiley Publishing, Inc. Production and abridgment copyright 2008 HarperCollins Publishers, Inc. So many people dream of moving into the country and away from the hustle and bustle of city life. Everyone gets tired of traffic and smog and long lines and crowds. Getting back to the simpler life so often seems like a dream that you wonder why you didn't do it sooner. If you have preconceived notions of what farming is like today, you may be surprised. Rural families don't necessarily spend all day in overalls on the back of a tractor or in the kitchen donning an apron and baking pies. Every farming operation is different in size, products, use of technology, and so on. Farmers fill a variety of roles: mechanic, veterinarian, carpenter, gardening expert, and accountant. And although taking on so many mini careers at once may seem daunting, you can pick up experience on the job. We moved to a farm from the city about 10 years ago. Yes, we've had some hard times, such as dealing with blizzards and droughts and numerous power outages, but the whole experience has been so wonderful for both of us. And in the summertime, when we go out to harvest, it's such a joy to cut up a tomato or zucchini and know that we made that. If you likewise delight in an accomplishment such as growing the biggest tomato in the county, or seeing the birth of a calf, or making a salad using the wonderfully tasty veggies you grew yourself, then this is the life for you. If you like to get your hands dirty and put in some hard work, hobby farming is very likely going to be all you dreamed of, and more. We learned a lot in the first few years of playing with this new toy, the farm with animals, and as I share some of my experiences with you, I hope to encourage and inform you so you're more prepared to go for your dream. So you think you want to move away from the hubbub of the city and move to the peaceful life of the country. Doing that offers so many rewarding consequences, but you also have to keep some challenges in mind before taking the plunge and buying the farm. After all, you want it to be a pleasant experience that doesn't do you in. One of the best parts of hobby farming is the wonderful feeling of getting your hands dirty, growing a small crop of farm-fresh vegetables, and ending up with something you can actually eat and enjoy. Or perhaps you experience the joy and wonder that occurs after you care for a pair of animals who've given birth. You can proudly show off your crops and newborns to your friends and relatives, saying, "Look what I did." But the downsides include simple inconveniences, such as being farther away from the grocery store, eateries, or even the fire department. Most farm areas are also more exposed to dangerous weather just because they're out in the open. And then you face the issues that come from drought, insect attacks, and too much work but too little time. But with all the trade-offs, you just may find the country life is the best thing that ever happened to you and wonder why you didn't embark on that journey sooner. Think about why you're considering the move and the lifestyle change. Are you trying to escape the city, or do you truly enjoy being one with the earth and getting your hands dirty on a daily basis? If escape from city hassles is your motivation, just be aware that you're trading one set of hassles for another. Moving from the city or suburbs to the country isn't always a smooth transition, especially if you decide to build your own place. For instance, if your homestead isn't close enough to the city's or county's services, you may need to get your own propane tank or use some other alternative power source, dig a well that can cost several thousand dollars, and set up a septic system to deal with household wastes. Besides the initial costs of building these types of systems, you have to put in time and money to maintain them. Even if public services such as power, water, and sewage are available, you'll still run into some problems: power outages, road washouts, or a drought that can threaten your crops. Ask yourself whether you're willing to deal with the trade-offs, such as not having the opera nearby, but instead going to the local high school musical for your cultural entertainment. Are you willing to give up short trips to the store for clean air and a quieter life? And consider the concept of fitting into the neighborhood. You want to do your thing without making enemies of those who are already up and running. Respect what's already going on, and try not to make big changes that may cause rifts between you and your neighbors, such as deciding you don't like the odor coming from your neighbor's pig farm and attending every city council meeting to voice your opinion about it, hoping to get the operation to cease and desist. Making a big investment in land, animals, and equipment means you can get yourself into a situation where you can't easily walk away. Look and smell before you buy. And of course, farming is hard work. There will always be a fence to mend, an animal shelter to build, or planting and canning to tackle. Although many tasks can wait, some of them have to be done immediately. Despite the challenges and rigors of farm life, you do get some benefits that you don't find elsewhere. Quiet streets, being able to see stars and meteor showers at night, and neighbors who tend to look out for each other and lend a hand when needed. Growing your own food and knowing just what kinds of processes and chemicals were involved, if any, is one of the joys of farm life. And homegrown fruits and veggies just taste better. After you've eaten your own fresh-from-the-garden tomatoes, you won't be satisfied with a store-bought one again. Having animals can be a lot of fun, but a lot of work as well. You can raise animals merely for the joy they provide, or you can get them to help you in some way by pulling equipment, giving you meat or fresh eggs, or giving you fiber that you can turn into beautiful fabric. Your motives for moving to a farm, whether you want to raise plants or animals or both, tie in with choosing a location. And if you're not going solo, a lot of what you decide depends on what the rest of the family has to say, because everyone wants some input on such a big change. The bottom line is that you need to look at a lot of interrelated issues that go into making your farm dream come true. Whether you're looking at a true hobby farm, as opposed to a fully for-profit farming venture, clearly impacts your perspective on the shape your farm should take. Hobby means doing something for the fun of it, not necessarily to make a living. Moving to a small hobby farm means you'll likely be pouring more money into it than you get out, if you get something out of it at all. And most likely, you'll be working in your real job and commuting into town every day. This leaves less time for your farming chores and challenges. If you're looking to go after a for-profit venture, your decisions will be quite different. Odds are, if this is the case, the farm will be your only job, so you need to put more thought into planning, management, budgets, and marketing. If your bottom line depends on what you put into and subsequently get out of the farm, you may not be as free to buy all those fun toys that tempt you, such as a backhoe or a top-of-the-line computerized greenhouse. You'll need to be prepared to suffer monetary losses, and these can be substantial, until you're able to get the farm fully productive and then profitable. Before you can decide where to locate your hobby's headquarters, you have to decide just what you want to do with that farm. The best hobby farms begin with a vision, so think carefully about your goals. After you figure out what you want, you can think about what you need in terms of people, skills, time, labor, money, natural resources, and so on, and plan how to get there. What kinds of animals you decide to bring into your family is a personal decision. Each animal and type of animal comes with unique needs, some more demanding than others. You need to think about what's right for you. Animals all need to be fed and watered daily, and some need some extra care above and beyond those basics. And even within a species, individual animals have unique personalities and quirks that can be endearing, or more work than you signed up for. At the very least, you want some sort of alarm animal. Most people opt for a watchdog. Especially if your nearest neighbor is a mile away, a dog can contribute to your sense of well-being and can warn you if something is amiss. Dogs are social animals, so treat them as part of the family. Also, a couple of cats are great to have around to help keep the rodent population down. Everybody works on the farm. Here are some other animals to consider. Horses. Horses need the most amount of work because they have to be groomed and exercised daily. but they can provide a lot of joy when they take you for a ride across the meadows or up into the mountains. Fiber animals. Animals such as sheep, alpacas, angora goats or rabbits, and llamas have to be kept in such a way that their fur or wool is protected. Meat and dairy animals. You may keep some animals, such as chickens, cows, sheep, or goats, because you want them for the meat. Goats and cows are common milk producers. Health and nutrition is an especially big consideration for animals who produce anything you plan to consume. Companion animals. Not every typical meat animal ends up as dinner. Even cows can serve as pets. If you do bring animals into your life, you're responsible for their care. That means daily attention, as well as stepping in when they need more help. Even daily care can be a real chore. During a blizzard, for instance, you may need to trudge through the snow to haul water so the animals have something other than ice in their bowls. Also, animals do get sick, and when that happens, you have to deal with it or suffer the consequences. Sometimes animals have difficult births, and you have to help, or else the young one may not make it. You may end up with an animal who just doesn't get along with the rest of the herd. Deciding how to alleviate the situation can be tough, and you may be faced with having to get rid of the critter in some way, or if the troublemaker is a male, perhaps castrating him. That may be a very difficult decision. What if that male is your best stud and has produced perfect offspring? What many forget when it comes to animals is the need for a thick skin in order to deal with the harsh realities of life, and especially death, on the farm. Some newborn animals just don't survive. Sometimes you have too many babies in one year, more than your farm can support, and you have to give some up. Or favorite animals can become sick or injured and need to be put down. If you choose to have animals on your farm, you can expect to incur losses every year. Are you ready for this harsh reality? It can be particularly cool to be able to say that the sweater a friend is admiring is one that you hand-knit from yarn that you hand-spun and hand-dyed after gathering the fiber from the goat you raised. If you're going to expect meat from your animals, you need to find a reputable butcher or dress out the animal yourself. But in either case, you know where the meat came from, what the animal was fed, and how he or she was treated. Good care can go a long way to a better-tasting meat, milk, or cheese. As the commercial says, great cheese comes from happy cows. In addition to enjoying fresh country air, reaping the fresh fruits and vegetables of your labor is part of the fun of embarking on a hobby farm in the first place. Growing your own food can be so rewarding. You can't beat garden fresh fruits and veggies, and preserving produce allows you to enjoy the harvest year-round. Although some crops do well only in certain climates, you still have an abundance of choices for which fruits and veggies to grow on your farm. Your biggest limitation is how much work you want to put into the venture. For the best results, check with your local cooperative extension service to see what grows well in your area. Look for seeds at the local country store or go online to find an even wider selection. You can get your plants started on a healthy life in a lot of ways, from starting them in a greenhouse to using compost and fertilizers to dealing with pests. Going organic can be a little more work, but you may discover it's healthier for you and the environment, and other people may be willing to pay extra for your tomatoes if they are certified organic. Organic means using only natural materials in your crops. In other words, the fertilizers and pesticides you use contain ingredients that originated from organisms or living things. No artificial chemical materials are allowed. Part of what you choose to do with your farm may be related to how you want to interact with people and expose them to farm life. Get people to come to your farm and show them what life is like with a farm tour. Or let people come and pick their own fruits or veggies. Country folk enjoy some homegrown activities that just don't happen in the city, such as the county fair or farmer's market or a good old-fashioned barn dance. You can certainly run a vegetable booth at the market or set up a dance in your own barn. Farms offer so many opportunities for having fun that don't cost much at all. How much acreage can you handle? The more, the better may sound great at first, but consider that you have to maintain that land, which may mean doing a lot of mowing, controlling weeds, planting, harvesting, and even fence building. On the other hand, if you plan to start your operation small, you may want plenty of room for expansion. Is there anything exotic, either animal or vegetable, that requires a specific climate? What you want to grow or keep on your farm can impact where you locate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.